An operating system provides applications with access to the underlying hardware. It does so by exporting a number of services. At the most basic level, these services are directly linked to some of the components of the hardware. For instance, there is a scheduling component that's responsible for controlling the access to the CPU, or maybe there are even multiple CPUs. The memory manager is responsible for allocating the underlying physical memory to one or more core running applications. And it also has to make sure that multiple applications don't overwrite each other's accesses to memory. A block device driver is responsible for access to a block device like disk. In addition, the operating system also exports higher-level services that are linked with higher-level abstractions, as opposed to those that are linked with abstractions that really map to the hardware. For instance, a file is a useful abstraction that's supported by virtually all operating systems, and in principle, operating systems integrate file system as a service. In summary, the operating system will have to incorporate a number of services in order to provide applications and application developers with a number of useful types of functionality. This includes process management, file management, device management, and so forth. Operating systems make all these services available via system calls. For example, here are some system calls in two popular operating systems, Windows and Unix. I will not read through this list, but notice that although these are two very different operating systems, the types of system calls and the abstractions around those system calls these two OSs provide are very similar. About process control, creating a process, exiting a process, waiting for objects, creating files, etc.